All right, Sam, thank you. Australia has chalked up its slowest economic growth since the global financial crisis. It dropped to just 0.5% growth in the last quarter. Treasurer Josh Frydenberg joins me now from Canberra. Treasurer, we should point out this is for April, May and June, so it's a fair bit back in the past, isn't it? Are you concerned that the economy is growing at just half its average pace?
Well, of course, we want the economy to be growing faster, but the key point here is that the economy continues to grow. We've chalked up our 28th consecutive year of economic growth. That's a record, Koshy, that no other developed economy has matched. And that when you've seen Germany and Sweden and Singapore and the United Kingdom all experience negative growth in the June quarter, the Australian economy continues to grow. Now, these numbers do not take into account the tax cuts, the $14+ billion that has already flowed into the pockets of Australians, as well as the full impact of the 50 basis point interest rate cut. So these numbers show the remarkable resilience of the Australian economy, and it's a repudiation of all those who have sought to talk it down.
So the September quarter that we're in at the moment, you're seeing an uplift. So the half a percent is going to be as worse as it's going to get, no recession.
Well, the key point is the Australian economy continues to grow, and there are people out there who've sought to take glee and happiness, if you like, out of slower economic growth. We talk up the Australian economy, and we will see that $14 billion have an impact in household spending.
Yeah, we need to talk it up because there are a lot of doomsayers out there that have been proved wrong, but... Okay, it's travelling worse than the average. Pay rates are not going up. You've got two levers to pull, Reserve Bank and government. Reserve Bank's cutting interest rates. What are you going to do to stimulate the economy? What's the government going to do?
Well, infrastructure spending is a key aspect of our fiscal policy. And as you know, we've got a 10-year, $100 billion pipeline. The Prime Minister has written to the Premiers to discuss which possible projects could be potentially brought forward and started earlier. At the same time, those tax cuts are the most significant the Parliament has passed in more than two decades, with more than $14 billion going into the pockets of Australians. We're investing more in skills with 80,000 new apprenticeships, as well as more money going to health and education.
So no new initiatives, though?
Well, those initiatives were set out in the budget when we were very conscious, Koshy, of these challenges that we face. But if you look at the numbers, for example, our exports have grown.
Oh, booming.
And the free trade agreements that the coalition entered into are now producing those dividends.
All right, Treasurer, thanks for joining us. Appreciate it. Here's Dan.
Always good to be with you.